Hi guys, welcome to Algorithms Made Easy. Today, we will go through the day 28 problem from August LeetCoding challenge. Implement Rand10 function using Rand7 function. Please like the video and if you are new, don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you never miss any update. Given a function which generates a uniform random integer in the range 1 to 7, write a function which generates a uniform random integer in range 1 to 10. It is specifically mentioned, do not use system's math.random function. The very first method that we will be seeing is rejection sampling. There is a Wikipedia page dedicated to this topic. If you are interested, the link to it is in the description. Let's understand the basic idea that we will use in our video. Since we are given a function that generates a random number between 1 to 7 and we need to find out the number between 1 to 10, we need to find in the scope. Thus, what we do is we take this matrix that has 7 rows and columns. In this, we write the numbers 1 to 10 repeatedly. We see that the first 4 chunks of the number 1 to 10 are complete, but this one has only 9 digits. So, we need to reject any number or index that falls in this sample. Now, how do we know if the 7 appearing is from this one and not from the above sample? It is simple. Let's see it with an example. We will try to find a number between 1 to 10 using the Rand7 method. We will use the random function twice, once to calculate the row number and once to calculate the column number, and then return the number at that position in matrix. Now, if the function goes beyond 40, we recalculate it as it falls in the red part. Suppose we get row as 5 and column as 4. The index we need is for number 6 highlighted. How do we calculate the index? If we see manually, we know it is at index 26. That is, it is the 26th tile. But how do we calculate it programmatically? We see that we need the element sum from all the previous rows plus the number of columns from current row. This gives us the required formula shown. So, now that we have the index, we need the number it has. Since the grid has numbers 1 to 10, we can easily find the number using number mod 10, but we need extra care for indexes in multiples of 10, as in this case the number mod 10 gives 0. So, we can use either of the two formulas shown so as to get rid of 0 while performing the modulus operation. For our example, it gives answer as 7 or 6. Both are acceptable. At the end, we return the calculated number. Here's the algorithm for the same. The second method uses similar base understanding but a different approach to create the number. Rather than calculating the index, we create a two-digit number less than 40 using this technique. The Rand7 function gives me a single digit. We need to make it two-digit by performing the decimal digit creation operation. So, for units place, we simply use the Rand7 function. While for tens place, we multiply the output from Rand7 function by 10. The number generated with Rand7 function is from 1 to 7, so we need to convert it to base 0 by subtracting 1 from it. This will generate the numbers from 0 to 66. But as we need the numbers only from 1 to 40 as seen in the previous approach, we will discard the numbers if they are greater than 40 and regenerate the random number in this case. Taking this example, as 54 becomes greater than 40, we need to discard this and generate a new number. 32 satisfies the condition. So, we return number mod 10 plus 1 as we did in the previous approach and return 3 in this example. Here's the actual code snippet for the method. You can also check out the link to the code in description below. Thanks for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel. Also, let me know in the comments what you think about it. Keep learning, keep growing.